Greetings, my fellow music lovers. In this video, we will be looking at the chromatic circle and the cycle of fifths by analyzing traditional 12-tone harmony and applying what we learn to more exciting semiharmonic scales. First, let's look at the chromatic circle with pitch classes corresponding to what you'd find on an everyday piano. On the opposite sides of the circle, we have C and F sharp in a frequency ratio of square root 2. Moving around the circle once, we have a ratio of 2. And moving around twice, we get a ratio of 2 times 2, in other words, 4. As you can see, the circle is logarithmic, so 1.5 falls here, 1.25 here, and 1.75 here. In linear terms, these numbers would be equally spaced, but when perceived musically, we hear a big leap from here to here, a medium one from here to here, a small one from here to here, and an even smaller one from here back to our root C. Now let's drop the decimal notation and look at these as ratios. Historically, 5 quarters and 3 halves were considered consonant intervals, but as you may notice, the 5 quarters falls a little flat of what we're used to hearing as the note E. You see, it was decided that having all of the pitch classes distributed equally was so practical that we could afford to give up some of that sweet consonance. A highlight of this practicality is that the smallest step, the semitone, acts as what's known as a generator. We can simply repeat the same interval from note to note until we come back exactly to where we started from, but an octave up. Other generators are the major 7th, the 4th, and the 5th, the main topic of this video. Compared to the dissonant semitone, the sonorous 5th offers an excellent basis for music. Stacking 5 fifths on top of each other gives us the pentatonic scale. You'll notice that the gaps in the scale come in only 2 sizes. We can fill in the big ones by stacking one more fifth up and one down, giving us the good old major scale. This is where the fifth gets its name, as it's always the fifth note in the scale, no matter how you stack the fifths up and down, with Locrian being the exception, as you only stack the fifths down. Because it is built from fifths, we can easily move to a different major scale up or down a fifth, just by adding one more note in either direction. Modulating like this 12 times around the circle of fifths, we end up back to C major. Before we discuss semiharmony, let's take a brief historical detour. As previously mentioned, the justly intoned major 3rd, 5 quarters, doesn't fall nicely on the 12-tone grid. We can rectify this by using fifths. The major 3rd is constructed by stacking 4 fifths, so if we really enjoy the sound of 5 quarters, we can flatten our fifths ever so slightly to compensate. The resulting scale is known as quarter comma meantone, and it sounds like this. We can even modulate up the chain of fifths like before, but after 12 key changes we have a problem. We are not back where we started from. The circle of fifths has turned into a spiral of fifths that never repeats exactly. If I was to play this on a real instrument, I would have run out of keys at this point. However, for us digital artists, this is a mere inconvenience of creating more tuning presets. But the tiny shift in pitch, also known as comma drift, is something to keep in mind. If instead of flattening the fifth, we made it just a little sharper to exactly equal 3 halves, we get the Pythagorean tuning. Again, if we were to go up 12 fifths, we wouldn't come back to C, but now that we're dealing with an exact ratio, we can visualize the effect using gears. You'll notice that the speed of the final gear in the series matches the speed of the driving gear quite closely, but not exactly. This, I think, is part of the reason why we can't have nice things in music. One important consequence of using 7 fifths as our building blocks is that the resulting diatonic scale will have gaps of only 2 sizes, 5 large gaps and two small ones. Increasing the size of the fifth, and thus the relative size of the large gap, so that three small ones fit inside it, we get a diatonic structure for 17 equal divisions of the octave, or 17 EDO for short. The only structural difference from 12-tone equal temperament is that the flats are now distinct from the sharps. This is reflected in the circle of fifths, featuring all of the 17 notes. Widening the fifth further, we arrive at 22 EDO, something of a favorite in the semiharmonic community. Seventeen EDO and 22 EDO are what are called super-Pythagorean tunings for having a fifth sharper than the Pythagorean tuning. In super-Pyth, the minor intervals get flatter and the major intervals get sharper. Instead of approximating 5 quarters, 22 EDO's tack of 4 fifths comes very close to the septimal supermajor third, 9 sevenths. A good approximation to 5 quarters still exists, but its complexity has grown to 9 fifths, the augmented second from C to D sharp. If we increase the size of our generating fifth even further, the small gaps vanish and we get 5 EDO. So let's go in the other direction, by flattening our fifths until 5 small steps equal 3 large ones, and we get 31 EDO. This is very close to quarter comma mean tone, but with no comma drift issues. Flattening further, at 3 small steps to 2 large ones, we encounter 19 EDO. A great option for exploring semiharmony, where most of the musical concepts from 12-tone equal temperament still find their counterparts, but you get extra bits like harmonic 7th chords to play with. Going deeper, we finally hit 7 EDO, where the small steps are the same size as the large ones. There's hardly any harmonic motion left due to complete uniformity. Nothing is stopping us here, so let's push further. The relative sizes of the gaps now switch places, and we enter anti-diatonic Mavilla territory. All of the usual musical concepts still apply, but in reverse. Where there used to be major chords, you'll find minor, and vice versa. Diminished and augmented chords also switch places. Here's some Mavilla harmony in 23 EDO. Continuing in 16 EDO. And finally, 9 EDO. Mavilla has the weird property that what's notated as F sharp is actually lower in pitch than F natural. It's very interesting that we can have some sense of harmonic motion just by adding two more pitch classes compared to 7 EDO. Pushing further will cause F sharp to cross over with E flat in pitch, so 9 EDO is usually considered to be the flattest F it can be. However, the transposable structure of 2 small steps, 1 large, 3 small steps, 1 large, can still be musically interesting, so here's 11 EDO. And I just have to give an honorary mention to just intonation generated by the undecimal subfifth 16 elevenths. So funky. We also find 13 EDO in this supermavilla region. This is pretty much where the bus really stops. Any flatter, and we'd just be playing the tritone up and down. So let's take a quick recourse to something more familiar sounding. I happen to be a fan of the major sixth, 5/3, and it's unfortunate that quarter comma mean tone doesn't do it justice, focusing solely on the major third 5/4. We can create a minimax compromise by stacking 5/4 on top of 5/3 and adjusting the fifth until 7 of them match the combined interval. It sounds like this. And it goes well with distortion too. Remember how we stopped at 5 EDO due to the small steps vanishing? Let's break that barrier for fun and make the small steps negative. When 3 negative small steps equals 1 large step, we get a weird flavor of 13 EDO. Major and sus4 switch places, as do minor and sus2. So the harmonic structure is all out of whack, but modulations still preserve that structure, and the whole thing maps nicely to a standard MIDI keyboard if you don't mind losing a pitch class. Of course, using negative steps is not how you're supposed to view 13 EDO. In this case, a more correct way is to stack 8 fifths, arriving at a scale with a pattern large, small, large, small, large, large, small, large. This super diatonic region is also where we find 8 EDO. Although you're probably better off just stacking 5 fifths and working with a large, small, large, small, large pattern. As you can see, almost any EDO can be given a diatonic-like structure by using a respective fifth as the generator that results in a 2 large, 1 small, 3 large, 1 small structure that fits snugly on a standard keyboard. Here's a non-exhaustive table for reference. Some of these only generate the subset listed in the parentheses. For the 7 EDO is the smallest number of divisions that supports 2 different diatonic structures, and we have to reach all the way to 72 EDO to get something with 2 mavilla structures. Please note that this video only scratches the surface of moment of symmetry, as these scales with only 2 step sizes are called, but I hope you learned some basics about generators to continue your own studies. Thank you for watching. Remember to leave a like if you enjoyed, and let me know what musical topics you would like me to cover in the next video in the comments below.